I command healings of all kinds right now. At the count of seven, do what you couldn't do before.
In the name of Jesus, I reverse the power working against you. In Jesus' mighty name. You notice that a part
listen, what you call impossibility is impossibility before the God you serve. That thing that the world has used to laugh at you, it will become a testimony. It is your faith that will see you through your wilderness.
I release the miracles of your need into your hands this morning.
Somebody shout, it is mine.
Sovereign Word Church specially invites you to hold Shama 2015, a 21-day prayer and fasting program tagged Dealing with the Enemy Behind the Scene, Season 3, from September 14th to October 5th, starting by 6 p.m. daily at these locations: Number 11 Awori Street, Inekwal Haji Bus Stop, Egbeda, and Number 133 Obafemi Awolowo Way, Lagos State Arts and Culture Center, Radio Bus Stop, opposite Zenith Bank, Alausa, Ikeja. Ministering Dr. Antoni Okoh and Pastor Soji Elijah.
I'm inviting you for Hoshama. Now, from the 13th of September to on the 5th of October, we'll be meeting daily praying in our two locations, Ikeja and Egbeda. Now, the theme of this program is tagged Dealing with the Enemy Behind the Scene. Whatever is behind the scene that is not visible, holding back your miracles and your blessings, will be dealt with by the power of God as we pray and petition heaven for 21 days. I look forward to you coming with your family. Have a blessed day.
Call 0809-444-5052.
Foundational matters are not what you sweep under the carpet. They will trail you, they will haunt you, they will torment you. If something is not done deliberately to frustrate the activity around you, it will continue. The first assignment that was given to Samuel, to Saul, say in the name of Jesus. Say louder, say in the name of Jesus. You enemy. In my father's house. You enemy.
He's an enemy.
In my mother's house.
In my mother's house.
Standing before any altar.
Standing before any altar.
Shrine.
Shrine.
Calling my name.
Calling my name.
Servicing altars.
Servicing altars.
To afflict.
To afflict.
Torment.
Torment.
Harass.
Harass.
Our destiny.
Our destiny.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Your time is up.
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 Die.
Cease to function.
Die.
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 Die. Cease to function. Jam your hands and begin to pray. Paralyze them. 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 Rekoposataya. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
How many of you were in the Kedja church this morning? I called a man with a passport. Right? The man came to me after service. He said, Pastor, you are the third person telling me this. You are the third person. He will soon leave for America with no plan to come back. They'll be seeing strange revelations. And you know where the thing is coming from? From his workplace. He said, you are the third person. I called him out. I said, there's somebody with a passport here. And he came out. He said, you are the third. He said, yesterday, somebody called me and gave me the same revelation. You see the kindness of God. This man is on his way out. But there are things that have been put in place. See the way God is nullifying, neutralizing. I told him, I said, don't be afraid. I said, for God to use me now as the third person to reveal this thing, that means whatever they have planned will not come to pass. And I prophesy to you today, whatever the enemy have planned, it will not come to pass. As you say amen, their powers are destroyed. So the assignment was given to Paul, to Samuel. We find in verse 8 that he did the opposite. May that not be your story this year. In verse 8 of chapter 15 of 1 Samuel, Saul took Agag, the king of the Amalekites, alive and utterly destroyed all the people with the edge of the sword. Verse 9. But Saul and the people spared Agag and the best of the sheep and of the oxen and of the fatlings and the lambs and all that was good, and would not utterly destroy them, but everything that was vile and refuse, that they destroyed. The useless things they destroyed, but the key factors, he left them. Can I tell you how he died? Who did God send him to destroy? The Amalekite. If you go to 2 Samuel chapter 1, you find that the end of Saul came as a result of the sword of an Amalekite. The nation he was meant to destroy, that he spared, was the nation that killed him. Now look at it. What he refused to deal with did not only deal with him. He dealt with Saul. He dealt with Jonathan. Now after Saul, it would have been Jonathan. If you go on further, you discover that Mephibosheth broke his feet. 3 generations were wiped away because one man refused to end the battle. What we are doing these 21 days will not only affect your children, it will affect your children, children, children.
Sovereign Word Church specially invites you to hold Shama 2015, a 21-day prayer and fasting program tagged Dealing with the Enemy Behind the Scene, Season 3, from September 14th to October 5th, starting by 6 p.m. daily at these locations: number 11 Awori Street, Inekwal Haji Bus Stop, Egbeda, and number 133 Obafemi Awolowo Way, Lagos State Arts and Culture Center, Radio Bus Stop, opposite Zenith Bank, Alausa, Ikeja. Ministering Dr. Antoni Okoh and Pastor Soji Elijah.
I'm inviting you for Hoshama. Now, from the 13th of September to on the 5th of October, we'll be meeting daily praying in our 2 locations, Ikeja and Egbeda. Now, the theme of this program is tagged Dealing with the Enemy Behind the Scene. Whatever is behind the scene that is not visible, holding back your miracles and your blessings, will be dealt with by the power of God as we pray and petition heaven for 21 days. I look forward to you coming with your family. Have a blessed day.
Call 0809-444-5052.
I took his crown and his bracelet, the signature for authority. I took his crown and I brought it. Whatever is aiming at destroying you this month, you shall see their end in Jesus' name. So this matter, we are doing this 21 days, is a serious matter. Tell us, it's a serious matter. It affects your generations after you. Say it. Say it's a serious matter. Say to your neighbor, say it's a serious matter. Now we are looking at the subject of unrelenting battle against foundational altars. Unrelenting battles. We are not relenting. We're dealing with it to the end. In the book of Judges, chapter 6, we see a pattern here, verse 1 to 6. And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord, and the Lord delivered them into the hand of Midian 7 years. 2. And the hand of Midian prevailed against Israel, and because of the Midianites, the children of Israel made them the dens which are in the mountains and caves and strongholds. Here we see that Israel had gone into apostasy, and they began to deal with altars and idols. This eventually provoked judgment. Are you following? Every place idolatry is practiced, the consequences are grievous. Show me a nation that serve idols, I will show you a nation that come under abject poverty and the curse of God. Haiti, for example. Cotonou, for example. Show me a nation that serve idols. Show me a family that idolatry is prevalent. Show me a family where certain things are done. Show me a place where blood shed is carried out. Show me a generational lineage where some strange things have occurred. I will show you a generation that is sold out to the devil. So we find the Bible tells us that there was an invasion. There was an invasion against Israel. The Bible says they will labor, they will toil. When it is time for them to have their harvest, like September, October, November, December, these people will come against them from nowhere. Attack them, attack their harvest. They targeted the harvest. Targeted the harvest until this pattern continued. The Bible says Israel was greatly what? Impoverished. Lift up your hand. Say, every visitation that targets my harvest year after year, in the name of Jesus, I paralyze you.
I paralyze you.
I paralyze you.
I paralyze you.
I frustrate you.
I frustrate you.
This year.
This year.
You cannot.
You cannot.
I forbid you.
I forbid.
I resist you.
I resist you.
Your time is up.
Your time is up.
I stand at the gate.
Stand at the gate.
I stop you before you stop me. I stop you before you stop me. Every power targeting my harvest, as I jam my hands, fire, fire. You will not take my harvest. In 2015, I frustrate you. Powers from my father's house. Powers from my mother's altar. I frustrate you. I will not lose my job. I will not lose my investment. I will not come down. As the year comes to an end, I will go bigger, better, stronger. In the name of Jesus, I stand you. I stop you at the gate. I turn you at the gate. I stop you now. Ah, sekoparata. Jam your hands and pray, pray. You will not see evil in 2015. You will not cry the tears of 2014. You will not cry the cry of 2013. 2015 is your year of turnaround. As you jam your hands, I release angels. As you open your mouth, I release angels, warfaring angels. We stop the battle, we stop the battle, we stop the battle. We stop the battle, we stop the battle. That battle that is against your business, that battle that is against your joy, that battle that is against your finances, anti-marriage demons will frustrate you. That power that breaks relationship, that power that breaks businesses, that power that makes you go indebted, we come against the power, we come against the force in the name of Jesus. We're having a prayer service. This is not a preaching service. This is not a teaching service. Jump to your feet and say, never again, not again. Not again. Open your mouth and pray. This is Hoshama. It's a prayer service. Not again, not again, not again. Open your mouth. If there's a man to pray, there's a God to answer. Open your mouth and pray. Not again, not again. I forbid you. Not again, not again. Affliction will not see me the second time. Not again, not again. Open your mouth and pray. Force yourself. Force yourself. Force yourself. Force yourself. Come against the enemies of your harvest. Come against the enemies of your harvest. Come against the enemies of your harvest. Open your mouth and pray. Receive strength. Receive strength. Play that song. Receive strength. Open your mouth and pray. Receive strength. Receive strength. Receive strength. Receive strength. Open your mouth and pray. Pray. If there's a man to pray, there's a God to answer. Lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. God is on your side. God is on your side. Lift your voice and pray. Refuse it. Reject it. Refuse it. Reject it. Turn that battle at the gate. Open your mouth and pray. This is a prayer time. This is a prayer time. Open your mouth and pray. Jam your hands. Enemies of my harvest, enemies of my promotion, I come against you. Fire, fire, rekatuza epata, erabataya. Join me in the labor room of breakthrough. Breakthrough, 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 breakthrough.
Sovereign Word Church specially invites you to Hoshama 2015, a 21-day prayer and fasting program tagged Dealing with the Enemy Behind the Scene, Season 3, from September 13th to October 5th, starting by 6 p.m. daily at these locations: Number 11 Awori Street, Inekwal Haji Bus Stop, Egbeda, and Number 133 Obafemi Awolowo Way, Lagos State Arts and Culture Center, Radio Bus Stop, opposite Zenith Bank, Alausa, Ikeja. Ministering Dr. Antoni Okoh and Pastor Soji Elijah.
And I'm inviting you for Hoshama. Now, from the 13th of September to on the 5th of October, we'll be meeting daily praying in our two locations, Ikeja and Egbeda. Now, the theme of this program is tagged Dealing with the Enemy Behind the Scene. Whatever is behind the scene that is not visible, holding back your miracles and your blessings, will be dealt with by the power of God as we pray and petition heaven for 21 days. I look forward to you coming with your family. Have a blessed day.
Call 009-444-5052.